Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam, my name is Vieku, and today I'm setting up my material editor. Why? Because I installed new Windows, I installed Max 2024, so I transitioned finally from 2022 to 2024. And while setting up my material editor, I noticed that I'm doing a couple of clicks, which are not, you know, all default things in my material editor. So yeah, I decided to share what I do, why I do it, and maybe it will help you and make your life a better place. Check it out. But before I jump into the whole material setup thing, I just want to point out that Evermotion has a brand new website. Look at this. This looks awesome. Like, everything is kind of filled with images and it's much easier to navigate. Of course, the shop is also new. So the first thing that you can do is like choose if you need files for Mac, Cinema, Blender, Unreal, just FBXs, OBJs, Arc Materials, whatever. It's all brand new. So yeah, head over to Evermotion. The site is updated regularly. You have all the news and everything, but let's dive into Material Editor. So whenever I open up my Material Editor, one of the first things that I set up is, when you go to the material, you have Get From Selected. I like to have Get From Selected on my shortcut. So you just click X here and just type hotkey editor. And here I'm just gonna type Get From Selected, and I'm gonna assign a Control G shortcut. So you just assign a shortcut here, click assign, save it, and that's it. What will that do? So for example, if I select this lovely flower here, and if I just press Control G, it's gonna give me all the materials from that flower. So no matter where you are, if you're lost somewhere in your sea of materials, wherever, you just click Control G and it will just straight go to this. And this is super, super practical. I highly recommend you set any sort of shortcut for your Get From Selected. It's super practical. Next thing that I like to do is go to Options, Preferences. And now here you have multi-sub material options. I like to set that to 2. Default is 10. So let me just show you what it does. So when you have a multi-sub object, you drag it here, you have 10 material slots. But if you go to Preferences and set this number to 2, because most of the time, I personally, for my needs, I need 2 materials in material sub object. So you set any number that you like here. And now when you drag it, it's only gonna have 2 forever, and you can change it whatever way you like. So next thing that I like to do whenever I set up my material editors is set up these menus here on the left, plus these here. And I'm gonna show you in a second why that is actually useful and how you can make everything kind of nicely visible so you can see what's happening where and how you can reach and access whatever you need in no time. So right click here, new group. I'm gonna set up the nodes for general nodes of default, like default maxes nodes. So I'm just gonna type general and I'm gonna mark plus. Why plus? Because I can just clearly see that this is different apart from regular general section. So it's gonna appear here, you see, general plus. So what I do, I generally just drag all the nodes that I use frequently. So cellular, checker, I don't know, a lot of these. So I'm just gonna quick drag them now. Fall off, gradient ramp. So all of these mixes, etc. Now that you did all these, so I've set these up here. Now when you right click, you got that general plus here and you can easily reach every node that you need. Now I'm gonna set up this for general, for F-Storm, for Corona. I'm just gonna get actually a massive, massive window and I don't wanna have that. So what you can do, so I have maps. I will not use these because I'm gonna set up all those here. So general, Corona, F-Storm, blah, blah, blah. So what you can do, just right click on the maps, go to context menu options and just unclick show group. And when you right click, there is no more maps here. I don't need sample slots also, so I can just scroll down, right click, context menu options, unclick show group. And now you can set these all up. Another cool thing is when you set this one up, you can actually right click, edit group color, and you can set up any color you like for this. So it's kind of easy to navigate. How does this look in the end? Let me just switch to the max that I've already set up. As you can see here, I have my controllers here. So these are the ones that I'm using frequently. My F-Storm that I'm using, general that I'm using. Corona is empty because I don't have Corona as my rendering engine currently. If I switch, then these will be full. But how do they look when I right click here? So I'm just gonna have these. You see all the pluses? These are all my custom ones. And here I have all of the nodes that I frequently use. So whatever I need them, I won't have this giant list and it's gonna be easier to reach Materials I haven't changed because these are just the default ones and I'm fine with them. And yeah, that's generally how I set these things up. If I need for any reason, so for example, if I go to general and I'm missing a specific node that's not here, I can always click here under the maps section and here I have all of them and I can just pick, you know, one of those that you don't use very often. And that's it. That's how I just set it all up. And you just remember these colors and it gets super practical. And the last thing that I do whenever I set up my material editor is import this one little script made by Changsu. So what is the script all about? Remember when I did a review on the scripts and then I showed how Drop the Slate works? Drop the Slate is a plugin for Macs where you can just select a couple of textures from your Windows Explorer, drag them into material editor, and they're going to be converted as bitmaps of your current rendering engine. Well, Macs 2024.1 has that by default, and Changsu was kind enough to actually make a little script that just changes those bitmaps to the dedicated rendering engine. So you download the script here, you just go to cganimator.com website, you import it into your Macs, you open your textures folder here, and let's say I want to drag these in. So I'm just gonna drag them in directly and all of them are gonna be converted to FSORM bitmaps, and that's just how it works. If I switch my rendering engine to Corona and I want to drag these again, they're all gonna be converted to Corona bitmaps. So this is a super handy feature. So yeah, now Max 2024.1 allows you to, you know, do the multi-image drag into your material editor, and with this little script, which is free for you to download, you can make that script to convert things to your rendering engine. It supports V-Ray, Corona, Arnold, F-Storm, Octane, Redshift, so I believe that a lot of us will be covered. And that's it for today, guys. I hope you learned something new with this material creation tips. I hope some of these will stick. If you have a different way of doing stuff, please write them down in the comments. I would also love to upgrade my knowledge in this field. And yeah, see you all in the next video. Bye.